Now we are going to discuss properties of electric charge. First of all, we have to know what is the SI unit of electric charge. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. It is represented by capital C. Smaller units are microcoulomb. 1 microcoulomb is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb. 1 nanocoulomb is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb. 1 picocoulomb is equal to 10 power minus 12 coulomb. So these are the smaller units. Next, there are some practical units. For example, ampere hour. 1 ampere hour is equal to 3600 coulomb. Similarly, 1 faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. 1 faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. So these are the practical units. The relation between electrostatic unit, that is ESU, and electromagnetic unit, that is EMU, of electric charge is given by EMU of charge upon ESU of charge is equal to speed of light in CGS system. That is, 1 EMU is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 10 ESU of charge. 1 EMU is equal to 3 multi 10 to the power 10 ESU. ESU is also called Franklin or stat coulomb. Actually, this is the smallest unit of electric charge. So 1 EMU is equal to 3 into 10 power 10 ESU. Again, 1 EMU is equal to 10 coulomb. Therefore, 10 coulomb is equal to 3 multi 10 power 10 ESU. Therefore, 1 coulomb is equal to 3 multi 10 to the power 9 ESU or Franklin. So these are the relations between EMU and ESU. Now, as you know, during charging, when a glass rod is rubbed with silk, what happens? It becomes positively charged and this becomes negative charge. What happens during this rubbing? I have explained you that during rubbing, some of the electrons from the glass rod move towards the silk. Therefore, here there is deficiency of electron, resulting the glass rod becomes positively charged, and here there is some excess number of electrons, therefore silk becomes negatively charged. So glass becomes positively charged and silk becomes negatively charged. In this way, what you are seeing, when a substance gain or lose one electron, what happens? If it gains one electron, then it have charge is equal to minus E, where E is the magnitude of electronic charge. And when it lose one electron, it have charge is equal to plus E. So the amount of charge on any substance will be plus minus E, or plus minus 2E, or plus minus 3E, or plus minus 4E, dot 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 dot, and so on, plus minus NE, where N is integer. It means that charge is always integral multiple of electronic charge. This is called quantization of electric charge. This is called quantization of electric charge. Although this is microscopic, and in general macroscopic concept, we cannot realize the quantization of electric charge. But this is true electric charge over the charge material is always integral multiple of electronic charge. So this is all about the quantization of electric charge.